there appears to be an arms race underway between China and the Western world. Not the military weapons of mass destruction, but these are robotic arms designed to perform various functions on the two space stations currently orbiting Earth. A new European robotic arm is set to arrive at the International Space Station on July 21st. Given the timing of its arrival, it's inevitably drawn comparison with the robotic arm on the Chinese space station's core module, Tianhe. Let's take a look at both. We'll start with the Chinese robotic arms first. The Chinese robotic arm is installed at the back of Tianhe core module to inspect the docking ports and plays an important role in performing several tasks. The arm will be used to capture incoming spacecraft docking with Tianhe, to move the payloads and support astronauts during spacewalks. The 15-meter long arm attached to the core module of the Tiangong space station is capable of lifting objects weighing 25 metric tons. The Chinese robotic arm has sparked concerns in the US over its possible military application, such as grabbing other satellites. The arm is self-relocatable and can reach many parts of the Tianhe module through an inchworm-like movement. The arm is designed to connect additional modules to Tianhe to form the eventual Tiangong space station, a bit like Canada's robotic arm Canadarm, currently attached to the International Space Station. For comparison, Canadarm is 15.2 meters long, 15 inch in diameter, and weighs 410 kilograms. By docking with target adapters all over the body, the Chinese robotic arm can reach all surfaces. Recently, the Chinese astronauts used the 50-foot robotic arm to install cameras and other equipment during their first spacewalk. Now let's look at the European robotic arm. Soon, a piece of cutting-edge European technology will be delivered to the International Space Station. ERA, short for European Robotic Arm, will be launched on a Proton rocket from Baikonur Cosmodrome together with the Russian multipurpose laboratory module Nauka. This brand new Russian module will be ERA's home base for the next 10 years. The 11 meter long ERA arm can lift up to 8 tons and be operated with an accuracy of an astonishing 5 millimeters. One of the most impressive features of the robotic arm is that it can move hand over hand over the Russian module. With this freedom of motion and well-chosen location, ERA will be able to service the Russian segment of the space station, which is not in reach of the other robotic arms already installed. ERA is fully programmable and has several modes of automation. This means each mission can be prepared on the ground and then uploaded into the arm's computer, after which the astronauts on board can run and authorize each step of the mission. Theoretically, ERA could even work autonomously and run the mission all by itself. It also offers the possibility for astronauts on board to piece together a new mission on the fly if necessary. The arm will have several important applications to alleviate the work of the astronauts on the International Space Station. As crew time is precious and the safety of astronauts is paramount, the arm can be used for tasks which are described as the 3 Ds: dull, dangerous, and difficult. ERA has been specially designed for collaboration between man and machine. The astronauts can even operate the arm from outside the space station during spacewalks, using a remote control which has been optimized to be used by astronauts in bulky spacesuits. ERA offers a look into the future of space robotics and the cooperation between human and machine as we further explore our universe. Thanks for watching. Catch you in the next video.